I grew up hearing stories about my great uncle, a soldier in the 89th Infantry Division, who was stunned and shaken by what he saw when he helped to liberate Ohrdruf, part of Buchenwald. And I'll never forget what I saw at Buchenwald, where so many perished, with the words of Shema Yisrael on their lips. I stood with survivors in the old Warsaw ghettos, where a monument honors heroes who said, "We will not go quietly, we will stand up, we will fight back." And I've walked those sacred grounds at Yad Vashem, with its lesson for all nations: the Shoah cannot be denied.
I'm a very tired, old, and worn out man, and my eyes have long been blind. Most things that people say to me just seem to slip my mind. Oh, but the suffering and painful times that were in years long gone are still as clear upon my memory as the numbers on my arm. What will become of all the memories? Are they to scatter with the dust in the breeze? Who will stand before the world knowing what to say when the very last survivor fades away? When I hold my grandson close to me and his fingers trace the pattern of my tears, he asks me, "Grandpa, tell me, why do you cry? What is it that you fear?" Was another child who smelled as sweet and felt this warm, but he was taken from the four my eyes, and only I remained to mourn. What will become of in the breeze? And who will stand before a world that now wishes to deny? Or will they believe in someone who never heard the cries?
On my visit to Yad Vashem, I was given a gift inscribed with those words from the book of Joel: "Has the like of this happened in your days or in the days of your fathers? Tell your children about it. Let your children tell theirs, and their children, the next generation." That's why we're here. Not simply to remember, but to speak. I say this as a president, and I say it as a father. Tell our children about a crime unique in human history: the one and only Holocaust. 6 million innocent people, men, women, children, babies, sent to their deaths just for being different, just for being Jewish.
There is nothing I can say or do to make things change. Time has a way of passing by so fast, and like a fleeting shadow, no one will recall the faces of the past. What will become of all the memories? gives me comfort. It's all that I have left. Oh, I know that God in heaven.
Tell our children not only how they died, but also how they lived. As fathers and mothers, and sons and daughters, and brothers and sisters, who loved and hoped and dreamed just like us.